Hi, I'm Allie, and here is my video talking about why it is so important to have three meals a day and a snack versus having six small meals scattered throughout the day. This is a snippet from my full-length video talking about how to have a clean eating and healthy lifestyle. In this video, it talks about why three meals is so much better for you than six. I used to think that it was better to eat six small meals a day because there's so many doctors and nutritionists out there who say that that's better than having three big meals. But I bought a book on Audible called Gut by Julia Enders, and it was an amazing book talking about the connection between your health and your gut and what you eat. And in it, she answered one of the most mind-boggling questions I had. How long should you space your meals throughout the day? How long should you wait until you eat your next meal? So you know that rumbling in your tummy that you get when you think you're hungry? Well, actually, it's not your body telling you you're hungry. It's actually the sound of your digestive system fleshing itself out. After you've eaten, and it's about like an hour after your meal, the beginning of the small intestine closes. So it shuts off everything from your stomach downward. And then what happens is this thing called migrating motor complex starts to push all of the leftover food and bacteria out of your small intestine and then into your large intestine. Bacteria should not be in our small intestines. For the most part, bacteria should be in your large intestine. But what happens is if you're constantly eating and snacking throughout the day, that bacteria does not get a chance to be flushed out of your system, and it starts taking house in your small intestine. And that means that when the bacteria starts to eat your food before it's digested, it takes all the nutrients from you and it produces gas. And that is what leads to bloating. So you need to give your body time to flush out all of that food out of your small intestine, get it absorbed and into your large intestine. And here it is, the magic number, 3 hours and 45 minutes, give or take a few minutes. Once you've eaten your meal, you cannot eat anything until that 3 hours and 45 minutes are up. If you start eating again, then it's going to cause your migrating motor complex to shut off, and it's going to open that portal into your small intestine, and it's going to stop the whole process. And then once you're done eating, it's going to have to restart that whole process. You can drink water. Water does not seem to shut off the migrating motor complex. So if you have breakfast at 7 o'clock, do not eat anything again until 10:45 or 11. So that is why it's more important to eat three larger meals throughout the day, because then that spaces out your meals by that 3 hours and 45 minutes at least. But remember to drink water if you start to feel hungry. And so that's why I say that you should also have an afternoon snack, because if you're eating lunch at 11 or 11:30 and you wait until dinner to eat, that's like 5 to 6 hours of not eating. If you eat lunch at 11 o'clock, try to have an afternoon snack at say like 2:30 or 3. And that'll give you the boost you need to make it to dinner time. Of course, there are going to be times when you're super, super hungry and you just need to have a snack, and so you eat a snack. Well, that's not going to kill you. My rule of thumb is if I can let my body flush itself out at least once or twice a day, then that is giving my body the clean out it needs. Thanks for watching this video about meals and eating and how important it is to space your meals out throughout the day. Please like and subscribe for more tips and tricks on how to live a healthy lifestyle.